Chugga 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 chugga. Mini Sunday.
Yeah, that's our new
something. Not even a theme tune, really. I'm glad we didn't call it that.
I might, you know what, that might have to be something I turn into a theme tune. That's gonna be a great little sample. Yeah. So yeah, what are you talking about on this Mini Sunday?
So, we're quite excited at the moment about Mario Maker.
Yes.
We've been looking at all the pre-order options.
Yes.
All the ways that you can get it.
Yes.
Free styluses, free kind of books.
Free steelbook. You can get a diorama. Yeah.
Just various ways to buy different forms of paper.
Yeah, basically. if anything, I actually pre-ordered the one on the Nintendo store that has...
the Supreme paper.
Not the Supreme paper, no. It has a book and a pencil, like an IRL pencil. And then it comes with a stylus that you can use to be touching the Nintendo Switch screen to be doing all of the Mario making, right? Which is pretty cool. If you're using it like portable, that'd be quite nice.
That's the one bit that I'm like, yeah, that's worthwhile.
Yeah, it's a really you know, unique and prestige accessory that you get with it. Yeah, no, but I think if anything, I'm excited about Mario Maker just because maybe it will make me slightly good at Mario.
Had you played the previous one?
Nope.
Okay.
I didn't have a Wii U.
Okay. Oh, yeah, it was Wii U, wasn't it?
Like the rest of the world.
Because all I kind of know about it, really, from seeing, you know, people play it and all that sort of stuff, was that people would love to make the most difficult levels possible.
Yeah. I'm going to play some of those difficult levels when it comes out.
Okay. Because that was always the goal, wasn't it? Making really, really hard levels.
Making the hard levels, so then that way your controller would end up breaking, maybe. I'm going to have to get another pro controller, aren't I, just to make sure that I can break the one that I have. that's the easiest way to at least limit like damage, to go like, oh, I don't want to have to be a week without a pro controller, so let me get one now so I can break the one I have.
One specifically for this game. Out of all the games, out of all the games which were difficult, out of all the challenging ones, you know, Mario wasn't the sort of game that I thought you were going to think about buying a separate controller for. I'll be honest, like...
I mean, it's not Mario, it's Mario Maker. That's a very different ball game. I've seen Markiplier play this game with, like, the 100 Mario challenge. It didn't end well for anyone. I think the only way that Markiplier has raged more is when he was playing I Am Bread.
It does actually look quite fun. I just get a little bit grumpy because I'm like, great, I'm paying to make my own game.
Yeah.
Like,
no,
which isn't true.
If anything, that's one thing that because I watched the Nintendo Direct for this, and it really is quite cool because it has like a single player mode now as well. Like from the looks of it, some sort of campaign. It might include
like
some building, but it has like courses that are already made to kind of introduce you to the game a bit.
I wonder if in the story, because if not, this would be a great idea, just saying. In the story, if as you went through the pre-made levels, if there were small bits missing that you had to fill with like one or two blocks to introduce you to the kind of the building mechanics.
I wasn't paying enough attention to know whether that was a thing or not. I was mainly just looking at the pretty colours, I've got to be honest.
If it's not, it should be.
It should be.
That's a really good way to do it.
It's a really good idea. Hey, Nintendo, hit her up. What's your Twitter again? It's at BATVHobbit.
Something like that. Yeah.
Something like that.
I never know.
And of course, we have an Instagram, so we'll just tag her and stuff. Yeah. She came up with a great idea, everybody.
There we go.
Yeah. One thing I didn't like about the Direct, though, is that they then said, hey, you know, what a great way to buy Super Mario Maker? Well, why don't you get it using these game passes?
From what I can figure out, it's just, there's a benefit to them because you're paying an upfront sum. It's maybe like 100.
From the looks of it, it's like around about between, I think it's like £80 or something like that for the game pass. It gets you two games out of a list of specific games. So if you spend it on like the bigger games, like if you use one on Super Mario Maker and then one on something like Smash, you'd end up actually saving money. But then that assumes that you don't already own things like Smash and so on, right? And a lot of the games you can just get really cheap used on carts anyway, so it's not necessarily
it's a good idea. It's a good idea if you're someone who buys a lot of games and there's two coming out very current and you're like, you know what, I want both of them, might as well make a saving. Like, that's not a bad idea. I'm all for, like, having ways to make things cheaper, but it's just interesting the way it's implemented. Why not just have a store with a, like, they do the store with discounts and stuff.
Yeah.
And just why not do, like, if you just buy two games at the same time, we'd just give you a discount, as opposed to adding all these extra steps of buy a other, like, another item.
Yeah, I mean, if anything, like, the difficulty with it isn't even necessarily that it's a bad thing of, like, oh, it's an annoying way of, like, saving money, because it does save you money. It's just the what is it? It's just the list of games that you can get on this. I mean, if I
is it
try
quite
and look, it's
limited?
Really limited, yeah. So yeah, the voucher compatible games on the Nintendo Switch are things like Super Mario Maker 2, The Legend of Zelda Breath of the Wild, which everyone already owns, 1-2 Switch, which no one wants, Mario Kart 8 Deluxe, which everyone already owns, Xenoblade Chronicles 2, which, to be fair,
that's
pretty good game, right?
Yeah,
so there's
good.
There's one there. There's one.
There's Kirby as well, I see.
Kirby Star Allies, which realistically
we had,
like,
fun playing, like,
it,
the demo.
The demo was alright, but, like, it was only alright. Splatoon 2, which you don't even get, like, the single player mode with that. That's still separate DLC. Sushi Striker, which
that
is
was quite fun.
Fun, but, like, it's already overpriced. That
yeah,
it feels
like a cheap,
quid
cheaper
anyway,
game,
right?
Right?
It's Donkey Kong Country, which is good. So now we have the two games, Donkey Kong Country and Xenoblade Chronicles, both of which I haven't been interested enough anyway to buy, because, like, the £50, the $50 wasn't necessarily too expensive anyway, right?
You know what? If you haven't already got a Switch and then you decide to buy one and you're getting it for, like, somebody else and you know that they don't really have any games, then cool. If there's two games on there and you can make a bit of a saving, no problems. It's just, it is a bit limited. Like, you're only going to buy one set of the tickets.
It's also only for the people with paid Nintendo Switch Online memberships.
Yeah.
So, to be fair, there's some level of saving, but I don't see why we have to spend so much money to be able to make a saving in the first place. Like, I would have a better idea.
Just have
I
an
think.
Online
Just
discount.
Have a discount. Like, hell, I'm going to compare it again because it's
PSN,
really
right?
easy to compare. Let's even go to the best one. In my opinion, the best one. We don't even have an Xbox. An Xbox Game Pass, I think, is the best thing ever. Because it's you pay not a huge amount of money to have access to any of their first-party games that come out and play them.
Yeah.
And that's it, right?
Yeah.
And then you have PlayStation Network, which gives you some older games for free, but still gives you discounts on quite a wider range of games. Right?
It's pretty regular, it gets updated.
Exactly.
Or they do, like, flash sales and all that sort of stuff. So there's opportunities across the year to just be like, actually, I'm going to get something for 50% off.
Exactly. Or even, like, the 20% or the 30%, even, like, 10%. That's still something. Like, for most, you know, AAA games and main games, which come up to, here in the UK, £50, in the US, likely $50, $60. You know, it seems small, $5-6, but that's enough for, like, what? Rather than getting one game and that's it, you could get that game and an indie game, even if you're thinking about, oh, they want to grab more of your money, which isn't necessarily bad, right? With this, you have to literally spend basically £90 to get
a bit of
10,
a discount.
£15 off. It would just make more sense just to offer a 10%, 15% discount on some of these games every so often, and maybe refresh the discount list every 2 months.
It would make it easier as well. Like, I just don't, just the thought process of buying an arbitrary digital item to be able to access the discount is a little bit
unusual to me. Yeah.
Like, it just, why are we going through the extra step of, like, card details to buy a non-physical item to be able to have access?
And what's worse is that because the cost of these vouchers is set to make the most saving, you're kind of already locked out of a few games.
Oh,
like,
yeah, because you have to cover the total cost, right?
Exactly.
Like, otherwise, you'll have leftover funds.
If you were to get Sushi Striker and also something like Dragon Quest Builders, both of which are really good games, you're losing out on $20 worth of savings right there just by going for two games that cost less, right?
Yeah.
So it just seems like it would have been better to just go blanket discount, that's about it, rather than having this sort of, like, weird
middle ground.
Yeah, this essentially what is, like, a strange gift card, right?
It is.
I don't like this pass. However, I do like Super Mario Maker 2.
Yes.
So that's going to be on the channel when it comes out. Don't worry.
And styluses and lots of paper that comes with it.
Yes, paper and also a steelbook. Thank you very much for watching/listening, and goodbye.
Bye.